Hello and welcome back to another video on DBT. A lot of times when building out a data warehouse or any database for that matter, there's the decision of how do you want to actually store that information. Do you want it to be persisted data that's stored as a table? Do you want it to be just a view on top of another table? In DBT world, they offer four options out of the box for us to make those decisions, and they're called materializations. As it says here, they are strategies for persisting DBT models in a warehouse. And those four options are table, view, incremental, and ephemeral. I'll add a link to this so that you can go through and dig in a little further in terms of what all of these mean. For the sake of this video, what we'll focus on is how do you actually make these changes in your project and what are the two different ways that you can do it. One thing to note is by default, models are materialized as views. So going into any project, you have to understand that that is the default setting. Anything else, you have to change. The two options here, we have adjusting them in our DBT project file, and the other is on an individual model level using this config macro here. So let's go back into Visual Studio and into our project. For me, I have two subfolders here, one that holds the example models and another for the sample data that we've been working along if you've been following along in the other videos. If we were to do a DBT run right now, we would expect everything to be materialized as a view, not only because it's the default, but because we're also explicitly saying here to do everything in this staging folder as a view. So both of these actually fall under a staging folder as well. And if we look at the logs, we can see everything is deployed as a view. If we look in our data warehouse as well, we can see everything here has been stored as a view. Now, how can we change this? Let's say that we want to have everything in this example folder materialize as a table instead of a view. The one way we could do that is to add a new layer here and give the name of the folder, which would be example, tab in, and add this same clause here, but instead change it to table. So now this is saying, look at staging, example, and everything in here should be materialized as a table instead of a view. So let's run this again. We would expect to see two tables and one view. Okay, table, view. And when we look back in Snowflake now, we see that they have the two new tables and the view. So that worked as we expected. Changing it in the DBT project, I think, is the easiest way to do this, especially if you're organizing your folder structure in a way that matches what your actual warehouse design looks like. You can just pick and choose the materialization that you want. The other option here, let's say we want to get rid of this here, is to use that config macro here and do it on an individual model level. So let's copy this part here and go into one specific model, let's just say this one. And at the very top, we would paste this in here, close out that template, config materialize table. And you could do this as a view, you could do as incremental, just as you would in the project, but instead, what we're saying here now is only for this specific model will this take place. Maybe there's a scenario where you want everything except one or two models to be a view. This is a way you could do that. So if we run this again, we would expect one table and two views, but we have an error. What is this expected? Oh, I forgot to close out this here. Config, that has to close out. Try it again. So to review, everything in this staging directory here would be a view, except for when it gets to this model, it's going to be overridden by this function here. And we can see the one table for the first model, which is this one. If we refresh, that's what we see. So that's a little bit about how the materializations work in DBT. I hope you found this helpful, and thank you for watching.